I will work my fingers to the bone so we can retake our home. They set off another blast, my ears were
got someone down over here. Doesn't look good. Who's there? Fight me!
Anything out there? Forget how they drove me from my home.
Shelter. It's bigger than the others.
Find the Tallneck, Aloy. There's no time to poke around.
There is if I make time.
Stronger we grow. Our time is coming soon.
What signal is setting off my focus?
Down. saw that.
Fighting up ahead?
No. It's a mining operation. So long as you're quick, it won't affect you.
Oh, good. Another secret.
So long as King Itamen languishes at sunfall, coddled by his mother, he will never learn the true lessons of the sun. I have tried to instruct him, but the shadow of his mother's influence is upon him. I took him to the palace balcony to behold an offering of sacrifice in the ring, but he showed no thirst for it. He averted his gaze. Look to the sun, I told him. Do not shield your eyes. In all things, it is absolute. One day, it nurtures life, and the next scorches life away. It burns the skin of champions and wretches alike. Never does the sun show pity. That is the example a Sun King must follow. The example of your father. But before my instruction could take hold, she was there, clutching him to her robes, burying his face against her breast. How is a king to rule when he cannot even see? long as King Itaman languishes at sunfall, coddled by his mother. Every morning, I wake to the same nightmare. The same reality. Holy Meridian, in the hands of profligates. Debased. The spire, towering above the horizon like in a glittering spike through the center of my mind. Every daybreak in exile is a mark of failure. But the count of days runs thin. I will see Meridian retaken. The profligates slaughtered. A true king restored to the Mesa throne. In this, I have become an instrument of prophecy. My lord, the 13th king of the Karja Sundom was murdered. Cut down by cowards who mistook firm rule for madness. Ever the strong are beset upon by the weak. So he said, as the traitors launched their assault. As their cannons, forged by Osaram filth, toppled the battlements and burst the gates. I would have fought to the end. But it was his will, the will of the sun, that I lead the prince and queen into the west, to safety. My lord did not hesitate. He saw his fate. He looked into the sun, and he did not blink. With me, he sent kestrels, nobles, sun priests, and slaves. Killing all that stood in the way, I carved a path to sunfall. There, we joined others to gather the strength to take back our home. But our strength only faded, until the buried shadow was brought to light. When I first set eyes on the buried shadow, I trembled. Was I not the chosen of the sun? A blazing light of faith to shred and scatter darkness? Was it not my place to destroy this devil? But High Priest Bahavas instructed me in the prophecy and set right my frame of mind. The murder of the true Sun King broke the cosmic cycle short of completion. The whole world cast into darkness, doomed. To resume and turn the wheel of time would require more than sun and faith. All forces must combine, all halves of nature join to one cause. Shadow to sun, night to day. Even a buried shadow wants the wheel to turn, for without a sun in the sky, there can be no shadow. Never does the sun show pity. And yet, when my wife died in birthing, and in dying into the life of my child unborn, I pitied myself. My lord sensed this. But instead of casting me down for weakness, he cast upon me a radiant beam of honor. He ordered my kin buried in the sacred caves reserved for royals and heroes. Unimaginable. Never again would I doubt that I am the chosen of the sun. Never again would pity find a place in me. Not for myself or another. Refuses to come. I think of our wedding night. How you welcomed me to the marital bed. How after, when you fell asleep, I lay there watching your delicate face. For all its beauty, I detested its fragility. A rage swelled up inside me. I abhorred that bed. How its softness threatened to swallow us up. And that room, the stench of incense, the fine embroidery of the drapes, all of it weak. I slipped from the bed, threw open the casement, and lay naked on the stone floor, determined to spurn all seductions of comfort. But when I woke the next morning, you lay beside me, naked as I in the cold. Your body, stretched beside mine, seemed chiseled from stone. I saw you wake, instantly alert, like an animal ready to strike. You said nothing. You did not have to. Already you had shown me beyond doubt that we were meant to be.
A mural of Meridian and the spire. There's only one man big enough to wear this. Helis. This is his shelter? Not exactly fancy.
What would you expect of a fanatic? His only extravagance is his brutality.
So you know him?
Just enough to want to stop him.
What is this place?
A distraction.
There are several data points. Get me out of here, but first I need to crash the network. All right. Single-minded.
It gives him a focus that you seem to lack. Now how about finding that Tallneck?
It would not have been easy to drag the Tallneck down this path. Why bother?
Just find it and get to the top. Destroy the module and then get out fast as you can.
Sure is a lot of blasting up there. Sounds busy.
Busy enough not to notice you, let's hope.
I see it. We've got some kind of structure.
Climb it. The sooner this is done, the better.
I don't like this. It feels wrong.
Everything here is wrong. Just get to the module and destroy it.